So we will start unit number 5 of computer organization and architecture subject. Unit number 5 is about input output organization. And the course outcome of this unit is describe data transfer methods input output interface. So in this unit we will learn about how external peripherals of a computer system, that is keyboard, mouse, printer, scanner, magnetic disc, magnetic tap, okay, camera, then microphone, speaker, all these are the peripherals outside of the computer system, can communicate with the processor of a computer system. Okay, so look at this diagram. Here we are having processor and here we are having set of external peripherals. Now this processor and this external peripherals can communicate using three type of buses. We know that is data bus, address bus and control bus, along with the interface which is connected with every peripheral devices. So input output devices attached to the computer are also called peripherals. Means here we are having set of peripherals. These peripherals are communicating with the processor via three type of buses and an interface. Okay. Now with whatever external peripheral this microprocessor wants to communicate, first it will enable a respective interface which is connected with that particular external peripheral. Okay, suppose microprocessor wants to communicate with keyboard, so microprocessor will enable this interface and all other interface will remain idle, means in disabled state. Now we will learn what this interface consists of. So look at this diagram. This is the diagram of that interface which is connected between processor and external device. It provides communication between processor and external device. So this interface consists of four type of register. There is port A register, port B register, control register and status register. It also consists bus buffer, and this bidirectional bus is connected between CPU and interface. And here input output data buses are connected with the interface and external peripheral device. Now most important component of this interface is this timing and control unit. Every interface consists its own timing and control unit, and this control unit is having chips like CS, chip select, register select 1, register select 0, input output read and input output write. Now suppose this processor want to communicate with keyboard, so it will send a chip select signal to this interface. And every interface is having a common structure like this. Now suppose this is the interface which is connected with the keyboard. So this interface here, the chip select, this pin will get value 1. Means this interface will get enabled. After that, here we are having two register select pins, register select 0 and register 3. So these two pins can point up to 2 power 2, that is 4 registers. So we are having total 4 registers, port A, port B, port control register and status register. We can select one of the register using these two pins. Okay, if this is 00, we will select, it will select port A. If it is 01, I select port B. It is 10, it will select control register, and if it both are 11, means 3, so it will select status register, content from the status register. Okay, here we are having control signal whether the processor want to perform read or write operation via this interface. So this is the interface which is connected with between processor and external devices, which provides communication between processor and external devices. Now here, as I explained, suppose this particular interface whose chip select pin gets value 0, it means this particular interface will remain idle. If the chip select value is 1, then and then only that microprocessor can select one of the register from this. Suppose both the register S0 and S1, RS0 and RS1, we have these two pin, okay, will get value 00, port A register will be selected, on 01 it will select port B, on 10 it will select control register, and on 11 it will select status register. Now port A and port B register will carry a data from input devices, okay, which is connected with that interface, and control register will provide necessary control signals for the transmission of data between processor and external peripherals. This status register we are having will keep a status of a number of bytes transferred, number of bytes pending, okay, and whether the type of transmission mode currently being used and so on. So type of status will be indicated by this status register. Okay? So this is the topic number 5 for input output interface. So that's it.